Lord Lovel, he stood at his castle gate, combing his milk-white steed. Lady Nancy Bell come a-riding by, wishing her lover good speed, and wishing her lover good speed. Where are you going, Lord Lovel, she says. Where are you going, says she. I'm going a-riding and see, he says, strange countries for to see, to see, strange countries for to see. When will you be back, Lord Lovel, she says. When will you be back, says she. In a year or two or three or more, and I'll return to thee, and I'll return to thee. He had not been gone but a year and a day, strange thoughts came in his head. He thought he'd seen Lady Nancy Bell asleep as she was dead, asleep as she was dead. He mounted on his milk-white steed, he rode to London town, and there he heard the bells a-ring and mourning all around, around, and a-mourning all around. Oh, what is the matter, Lord Lovel, he says, and who is dead, says he. A lady is dead, Miss Nancy Bell, they say she was kin to thee, they say she was kin to thee. Go open her coffin, Lord Lovel, he says, pull down to me her shroud, that I may kiss her gay cold lips, and the tears come trinkling down, down, and the tears come trinkling down. Go dig my grave, Lord Lovel, he says, dig my grave, says he. I am not long in this world to live, for the loss, my love, of thee, for the loss, my love, of thee. They buried Lady Nancy in the old churchyard, Lord Lovel in the choir, and from her grave grew a red, red rose, and from his a briar, and from his a briar. They grew in the old churchyard, to the wonder of the town. They would have been there until this day, if the sexton had not cut them down, down, if the sexton had not cut them down.